All right, good morning, class. What you have to do is, yes, Priyanshit is correct. What you have to do is, first you will read any paragraph of any stanza very fast, fine, but the pronunciation should be correct. Sixte has done a very good job in read-a-thon, fine, and then first of all, you have to switch on your camera. Fine, you have to switch on your cameras while speaking. Read the passage, read a paragraph. It can be two lines, three lines, very fast. And then your speaking skills, see fever, without looking into the book, you have to recite the poem. Fine, I hope you have understood how to do that costume party. For that, you have to send me the work on my WhatsApp as well as I'll give you time to speak here also. Who wants to go first? Anyone? See, volunteer yourself. Otherwise, I'll start taking
names. Good morning, ma'am.
Dolly, you do not have to choose. You have to do both. There is no option. Shijana, check your network, bachche. Others can hear me. Is my voice audible to everyone? Anyone who wants to go first? 6B, everyone has to go. See, I'll start giving you the names. 6A, there were so many students who want to go. If there was not a single time that I have taken their name, that you go. They volunteered themselves and they did a very good job at it. Aryan, please go ahead.
My name is Aryan Vas. I am studying in class 6B. I am reciting a poem on seafarer. I must go down to the seas again, to the lonely sea in the sky. And all I ask is a tall ship and a star to steer her by. And the wheels kick and the wind song and the white sails shaking. And the gray mist on the sea's face and the gray dawn breaking. I must go down to the seas again, for the call of the running tide is a wild call and a clear call that may not be denied. And all I ask is a windy day with the white clouds flying, and the flung spray and the blown spume and the seagulls crying. I must go down to the seas again. I must go down to the seas again, to the vagrant gispy life, to the girl's sway and the whale's sway, where the wind like a whetted knife. And all I ask is a merry yarn from the laughing fellow rover, and the quiet sleep and the sweet dream when the long trick's over. The poet name is James Masefield. Thank you.
Very good, Aryan. A loud clap for Aryan. Excellent. Now, Aryan, take any book and read a paragraph very fast. Aryan,
long ago there lived a bold. Ma'am, I am starting.
Yes, please start.
Long ago, there lived a bold and fearless little girl in Bhojla village in Uttar Pradesh. Her parents had died when she was very young and she lived with her relatives. She loved to climb trees and swim in the river. She was also a willing worker and could stand long hours of strain and hardship. The villager liked her, for she was good-natured. Once when a leopard had attacked her, the girl had fought it single-handedly and killed it with nothing but a sturdy stick. After that, she was nicknamed Jhalkari, meaning the tigress. When Jhalkari grew up, she got married to a soldier in the army of Rani Lakshmi and went away to live in him Jhansi. That was how Rani chanced to see her one day.
That's
she
it,
shall be it. My companion.
Aaron, that's it. Very good. Excellent. And I can tell you that Aaron has scored full. He has recited the poem very beautifully and read it very fast. Great work, Aaron. Next. Yes, Avneet.
Ma'am, can I start?
Yes.
The Rani ordered, for she liked the girl frank and the cheerful manner. They become good friends, and every day the two young women went out riding together. They sent wrestlers and practiced shooting with revolvers and guns. Those were the troubled times, and everywhere there were numerous wars. The British had expanded their territory in India. They had a trading company called...
That's it. Very nice. Now recite the poem. Yes, Avneet. Yes, Anushka, you can do that also. Yes, Dolly, go. Avneet, I'll be giving you... See, which if you're not reciting the poem, in listening, in speaking skills, you're getting zero. And if you're not reading the passage or a poem fast, you're getting zero. All these two activities have your marks. It's up to you, whatever you have to do. And for costume party, please send your entries on my WhatsApp. And then I can ask anyone to present in the class. You just have to create one correct. You have to write props about one character from any book and one imaginary character. Using the both characters, create a short story. Half an hour it will take. Just half an hour. Yes, Avneet, start.
Ma'am, I have a doubt.
Ask.
Ma'am, that we can create our own stories?
You have to create your own story only. Using one character from the book you have read and one imaginary character.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Yes, Dolly, go next.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Jolly Arora. I read in class 6B. Today, I am going to recite a poem in front of you all. And the title of my poem is Sea Seaver. I must go down to the seas again, to the lonely sea and the sky. And all I ask is a tall ship and a star to sail hereby. And the wheels tick and the wind song and the white sails shaking. And the blue and the mist on the sea's face and the grey dawn breaking. I must go down to the sea again, for the call of the running tide is wild call or a clear call that may not be denied. I must go down to the seas again for the wild call and all I ask is a windy day with the white cloud flying and the flung spray and the blown plume must be and the seagulls crying. Thank you.
Very good, Dolly. Now read any passage, any paragraph or a poem very fast.
Yes, ma'am. One day a fox went down a well. He did not know want to, but the fell. With the whiz, with a whoosh, in a flash, he hit the water with the splash. Now I have had it, cried Mr. Fox. I It's just like being in a box. It's down here and I'm alone. He moaned aloud and gave a groan. After a while, he calmed right now. When he was sure he would not drown, I have got myself in a quiet scrape, so I must try not to escape, said Mr. Fox as he swam round till some solution could be found. Now to that, right, will there come a ghost?
Okay, Dolly. Very good. Excellent. I really like the poem, though. You recited very beautifully. Yes, Vanshika, but you just have to read. For read a thorn, you just have to read 3 or 4 lines very fast. That's it. And class 6B, I'm telling you again, this is not a choice. You have to do both of them. Costume party and read-a-thon. I have not written or anywhere. So it is not a choice given to you. Yes, Vanshika, go next.
Ma'am, let me start. Ma'am, firstly, I am reciting the poem, The Sea Fever.
Okay.
I must go down to the sea again, to the lonely sea, and all I ask is a tall ship and us to stay by, and wheels cake and the wind song and the white sailing shaking and white sails shaking and the gray ice on the sea's face and drown breaking. I must go down to the seas again, for the call of the running tide is a wild call and a clear call that may not be denied. And all I ask is a windy day with the white cloud flying and a flungy spray and blooming spumy and seagulls.
Vanshika, are you reading from the book?
I must go down to the sea again.
No, ma'am.
Okay. Continue.
And all I ask is a merry yarn from a laughing yellow roll and quiet sleep and a sweet dream when the long trek over.
All right, now read something very fast.
Ma'am, I am reading the poem.
Read it.
Are happy and there are those that finish in glory. Is there a happy ending to every day? Maybe not when you are filled with grief and it's not to stop raining and the sky is gray. Happy ending are made by you. It's how you work and go about it. Can make that ending come true. Just be yourself, however small this, and smile when things we get out of honeymoon.
Very good. That was very fast. Ayush, go next.
Good morning, teachers and my dear friends. My name is Ayush Kushwaha and today I'm going to tell you a poem. The poem name is Happy Endings. Is there is always happy ending to every song and a story. Some are happy and some other are view. And then there are those that finish in a glory. Is there a happy ending to every day? Maybe not when you are filled with grief and it's not stopped raining and the sky is grey.
You're reciting the wrong poem. You have to learn Sea Fever for the recitation. Or you are reciting it for read-a-thon.
Sorry, ma'am.
Have you learned Sea Fever?
No, ma'am.
Learn it by tomorrow. I will listen from you tomorrow.
Okay, ma'am.
Now read the poem or any paragraph from the book very fast.
Okay, ma'am. Now said Manju impudently, tell me what we're going to watch his procession. Walk fast, we may be late. What procession? What procession? Where? The college students are talking out procession from their college to collector office. Mohan told me we could watch. He says it is going to be peaceful. Presently, Manju and Babu found a good spot almost opposite to the gate of the collector office. They had to wait all for right. some time. So,
all right, Ayush. Very good. Yes, Arpita, go next.
Ma'am, can I read first readathon?
Yes.
The northeastern region of India, consisting of seven states, is a place of diverse cultures. Different communities and tribes of northeast India celebrate their unique festivals with great enthusiasm and joy. Many of the festivals are based on agriculture, and no celebration is complete without traditional music and dance, blessed with lush greenery and the mighty river Brahmaputra. The people of Assam have a lot to celebrate. Bihus are among the biggest festivals of the state. The different Bihus in different seasons are celebrated by people of all regions, religions, castes or tribes. They mark the beginning of and end of the harvesting season and the completion of sowing. The Bihu dance is a joyous one performed by the both young men and women. It is noted for its break steps and hand movements.
Very good. Now we can recite the poem.
Ma'am, I have not learned sea fever.
But I have given you this work on Sunday, I guess. Today is Thursday. 4 days at home. I'm still not learning. By tomorrow, if you learn, learn. Otherwise, I'm giving you a zero. I'm telling you, everyone, those who are reciting in the poem, those are reciting here, fine, today or tomorrow, that's up to you. By tomorrow, if you're not doing, I'm giving a zero. Yes, Karthik, go next. At least do readathon right now. In that, nobody should have a problem. Yes, Dhani, go next.
Hello everyone, I am Dhvani of class 6B. Ma'am, 1 minute. Hello everyone, I am Dhvani of class 6B and today I am going to recite a poem on sea fever. I must go down to the seas again, to the lonely sea and the sky. All I ask is a tall ship and a star to see her by. And a wheel's kick and a wind song and the white sails shaking and a grey mist on the sea face. And a grey dawn breaking. I must go down to the seas again for the call of the running tide. Is a wild call or a clear call that may not be denied. All I ask is a windy day with the white clouds flying. And a flung spray and the blown fume and the seagulls crying. I must go down to the sea again to the vagrant crispy life. To the gulf way and the whale's way, where the wind is like a whetted knife. And all I ask is a merry yarn from the laughing fellow rover, and a quiet sleep and a sweet dream where the long trip is over. Thank you. The poet name is John Messerfield.
Very nice. Now read something very fast.
Okay, ma'am. As Christmas neared, there was an air of excitement in the house as if this was going to be an unusual happy Christmas for all of them. Joe and Lori, their next door neighbor, ran about mysteriously and could be heard laughing beyond the hedge. When Christmas Day came at last, it brought good tidings of great joy. Mr. March has written that he would soon be with them. With Beth felt left in a sausage by the window, wrapped in the bright red shawl mother had gifted her, and in the garden stood in the beautiful snowman that Joe and Lori had made, and then they gathered in the parlor to open the parents' presents. Right. Thank you.
Excellent. See, this is an activity going on. I have written down some names. Three till now, Aaron, Vanshika, and Dhwani. After we are done with these activities, I have given marks to everyone. Then I will conduct the contest between the students. I am writing down the name for finding out who is the fastest reader. Fine. Who will go next?
Ma'am, can I?
Yes, sure. Is the party switch on your video?
My name is Sharad Tripathi. I am class 6B and I want to read sea favor. I must go to down in the sea again, the lonely sea and the sky. And eyes to turn sharp in a star hereby. And the wheel kick and the wind song and white sing. And gray must in a sea face in a grayly down in a breaking. I must down to sea again and for sail. Of the running tide, it is wind call and clear call that may not be dended and asked windy day with the white cloud flying.
All right, Charya. Now read something very fast.
Okay, ma'am. The road divided into yellow wood and a story cloud travel both, and the one traveler long and stored and locked down with the fast. The ride. Ma'am, just wait a minute.
Okay, sure. That's it. I have read. Okay, Priyanshi, go next. At least do readathon if you have not remembered or learned the poem. That's okay. Do readathon. Everyone can do readathon today. You just have to read one or two lines very
can
fast.
I?
Yes, Priyanshi, I told
can
you.
Can I? Already.
Yes.
Okay, ma'am. I'm reading. We know that it is impossible to see the earth, entire earth, at the same time. This is during to the big size and spherical shape of the earth. Even photographs taken by the satellites show only half the earth. Therefore, a model of the earth can help us to view the entire earth. Thank you.
Very good. Have you learned the poem?
No, ma'am. Sorry, I have not learned the poem.
Learn it by tomorrow if you want marks. And next, who will read? Yes, Priyanshi, you can read from any book. Anushka, go next. After Anushka, Soumya, you can take the turn. Yes, Anushka.
Good morning, everyone. Today, I, Anushka Chaudhary, is going to read the poem Sea Fever. I must go down to the seas again, to the lonely sea and the sky. And all I ask for the tall ship and the star to steer her by. And the wheels kick and the wind song and the white sails shaking. And the green mist on the sea's face and the gray dawn breaking. I must go down to the seas again for the call of the running tide. It's a wide call and a clear call that may not be denied. And all I ask for the windy day with the white clouds flying and the flung spray and the blown spume and the seagulls crying. Thank you. This poem is written by John Westfield.
Very good. Read something.
Ma'am, it's a poem of another book. Can I read it?
But yes, yes, anything you can read.
The poem's name is Different. Just because I'm different and hear a different song or march on an odd number doesn't mean I'm wrong. Just because I'm different and don't dress the same or have a different opinion doesn't mean I'm wrong. Just because I'm different and don't work from 9 to 5 to earn an annual wage doesn't mean I'm on the Skype. Just okay, because I'm different.
That's it. But so just one stanza or one paragraph. So I'm going to go next. Yeah, I'm please wait. No, but you know. Please wait. Do not interrupt in between. Soumya, unmute yourself. Okay, yes, go, Soumya. My network is okay. Priyanshi, you can go next. No. There is a lot of disturbance. Soumya, refresh it, yaar. Bachche, please. I'm not able to hear you. Yes, Priyanshi, unmute yourself on your video. Okay, Soumya, you go. You try.
Can I stop?
Yes, Soumya.
Many years ago, there lived in China two friends named Kibu and Maushu. Neither had cross words nor unkind thoughts marred their friendship. They were true friends to each other. Kibu and Maushu were tired of life in a city and one day they decided to take a stroll together. It was a bright day and a beautiful day in early spring. We then forgot all our worries in the city.
Okay, so
ma'am, can I take the poem tomorrow?
Okay, so ma'am, not an issue. Okay, Harshita, go next. Harshita, sorry, Pratiksha, go next. Pratiksha.
Ma'am, can I read it?
All right.
Read me the
answer. Okay, yes, Priyanshi, go. Priyanshi, Harshita, Pratiksha, any one of you can go ahead. You can start. Okay, Priyanshi is starting. Start reading.
Good morning and good friend. Name is Dal. I am speaking about the road.
My topic is truth driven mindful study. Albert is just born of the 87 Chinese children without addiction. Everyone fits in the country. Even mother, all Albert's raised to his half seem class. At age 2 and a half, he himself was not up. But finally learned to speak Albert as a child.
All right, Priyanshi, that's it. Pratiksha, go next.
Hello everyone, my name is Pratiksha Verma. I'm reading in 6th B. I am reading a poem, Happy Ending. Ma'am, can okay. I start now?
Yes, yes.
Is there always a happy ending to every song and a story? Some are happy and other web. And then there are those that finish in glory.
Very good. Kanika, go next.
Yes, ma'am.
Go next.
Ma'am, can I read? Ma'am, can I read the story?
Yes.
Good morning, teachers and my dear friends. I am reading a special gift. Little Woman, it is a directed story about the March sister, Mary Jo, and Beth and Amy. In this excerpt, we read about how the March family find out the time for joy and Thanksgiving despite their problems and celebrate a joyless Christmas. A Christmas New Year, there was an air excitement in the house as this was going to be an unusual happy Christmas for all of them. Jo and Lovie, their next door neighbor.
All right. Run yes, that's up, it. All right, class, since the time is less, see, you can send me the recordings for readathon also. Yes, Vanshika, you can do that. You can send me your recordings of readathon as well as your stories on my WhatsApp. You'll get marks for that. But about speaking skills, I will take in the class only. Fine. Still have any doubt, you can WhatsApp me. Have a nice day. Please learn the poem and we'll continue tomorrow. Bye, everyone.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.